praise the Lord. In his presence, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. This is Salvation and Revelation on 92.9 FM. Your life, your salvation, and your choice. God bless each one of you who have tuned in this evening to hear the word of God. The Bible says that as you seek him, you will find him. Amen. Shall we pray? Father, we say thank you for another opportunity where we can hear your word, O God, that is written, that is already proclaimed, O God, through your spirit, O God. The word that you spoke was spirit and it's life, O God. So we say thank you, O God, for spirit life in your word. Father, as we come before your presence, we ask you, O God, to take full control that whatever is said, whatever is done will be in accordance to your word, O God, nothing missing, nothing lacking, O God, that, Father, we'll all grow in grace, O God, that someone will come and tell you this evening and said, yes, I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. I confess him as my Lord and soon coming King, and I put him first place in my life. O God, Father, Lord God, your goal is that, O God, you came, O God, that the world through you might be saved, O God. So I decree salvation for someone who do not know you as Lord and Savior, O God. Time is winding down, and we know, O God, Father, that you are preparing a show, O God, that one day you'll come back to take your children home. So for that one who do not know you as Lord and Savior, I decree and I declare that Jesus Christ is Lord over your life. And Father, O God, I ask you to draw not by might, not by power, but by your spirit, someone, and that someone is you on this evening. So I decree and I declare by the power of the Holy Spirit that Jesus Christ is Lord over your life. As you have tuned in, I decree salvation is yours. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. Now, Father, O God, we ask you for the power of your anointing, the power of your Holy Spirit, to, O God, rightly divide your word of truth, that whatever is spoken, O God, whatever is taught, whatever is preached, it will be, O God, according to your word, Lord God. Father, nothing will be added to it, O God. So we say thank you, O God, for accuracy in your word, O God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, O God, that, O God, your people will be lifted up, edified, comforted, O God, consoled, O God, Father, knowledge, wisdom, understanding, O God, and that we all will become doers of your word, not just hearers. In Jesus' name, we say thank you, Holy Spirit. So it is and so it shall be. We thank you, O God, for your presence in this place, O God. Fill this place with your glory. And thank you, O God, for all those who ministered your word. We bless you. We thank you, O God. And we all will grow in grace together and make it into your kingdom. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen and amen. I wanna
be close to you. I wanna be close to you. Come on and wave your hands and tell him that today, God. I wanna bask in the presence of you. For in your presence I find the fullness of joy. Anybody know that they can find that? You give me reason to smile through my tears. In your presence, Jesus, hallelujah, oh God. I feel your presence, yes, God. I feel your presence, yes, Lord. Your presence, yes, Jesus. Oh, it's where I long to be. Thank you, Jesus, oh God. I feel your presence.
I feel your presence.
Oh Lord, your presence.
Your presence.
It's where I long to be.
It's where I long.
Hallelujah.
To
come
be.
On and tell him again. I feel your presence.
I feel your presence.
Oh, he's moving about the building.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We want to be in his presence, and in his presence there is fullness of joy. Amen. Hallelujah. So today, if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, I just want to urge someone that time is winding down. We are in a time when we need to know for sure whether we are saved or not. And sometimes you may feel that you are saved, Amen. Salvation is not about a feeling. Amen. Some people says, you know, like, I know God, I know him more than you do. And it's not about how much you know about God, but knowing him as your personal Lord and Savior, that you have had a born again experience and you have accepted Jesus Christ as the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords of your life, that he's the first place, the first person, the most important person in your life. Amen. That you have confessed him with your mouth and you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ came and he paid a price, that you will be saved, that you will enter into rest when you leave this life and you enter into eternity. You will hear, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." You will know that your sins are forgiven, that no matter what you have done, that salvation is available to you and that you have received that forgiveness. Amen. Many times, sometimes we may feel that we are saved. Amen. It's not about a feeling. Salvation is not feeling, it's about faith. Amen. So the Bible says in Hebrews 11 verse 6 that without faith, it is totally impossible to please God. Who comes to God must believe that he is God and that he rewards those who diligently seek him. Even on this evening that you have tuned in to hear the word of God, it means that you are diligently seeking God, because you could have been someplace else doing some other thing, but you made a choice to listen to this program this evening. And for this, may God bless you. May God strengthen you. May salvation, I decree salvation for you. If you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, that I just want to say to you this evening, it's not okay to just tune in and just listen. God wants you to become now a doer of the word, not just a hearer of his word. Amen. Amen. He said, "He that believeth on us." As a matter of fact, if you have your Bibles and you turn to the book of John, and praise the name of the Lord, John chapter 3, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Chapter 3, that's in the Gospels, chapter 3. And I always advise that when the Word of God is read or taught or preached, that get a pencil, paper, write the scripture down, go back, search the scriptures, because many false prophets and teachers are gone on to into the world to possibly deceive even the very elect. We are living in very trying times where there is a lot of deception. Satan is going to deceive the whole world, and you do not want to be caught in that deception. So know God for yourself, know the word of God, stay in the word of God, read the word of God yourself, search the scriptures, and ask the Holy Spirit to teach you by his power. Praise the name of the Lord. He said, "He that believeth," John chapter 3 verse 36, praise the name of the Lord. Verse 36, John chapter 3, reading verse 36, we just want to see something in the word here. He said, "He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him." Praise the name of the Lord. So God is clearly stating, he that believeth on the Son, not he that feeleth about the Son. Amen. Sometimes we feel things that are not real. So faith and feelings is two totally different things. Salvation is not about feeling, it's about faith. So we see that is said right here in the scripture. He that believeth on the Son, meaning that he that has faith that Jesus Christ is Lord, he that believeth on the Son has everlasting life, which is life that will go on forever and ever, eternity. He says, and he that believeth not the Son shall not see life. Amen. So if you do not believe the Son, then you have death. Amen. Damnation. He said, and but the wrath of God abideth on him. It stays on you. So you have a choice to believe. This evening, the Lord is saying to someone today, I am setting before you life and death. Choose life. Again, I'm going to read the scripture. John chapter 3, verse 36. He that believeth on the Son has everlasting life. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is Lord? And he said, he that believeth not the Son shall not see life. If you do not believe, then you would not have life eternal. Simple. Praise the name of the Lord. He said, but the wrath of God abideth on him. Not just that you're not going to have life, but God's wrath rest on you. Praise the name of the Lord. We have to be wiser. The Bible says, be wise as a serpent and be harmless as a dove. God has given us his blueprint as how we can get into his kingdom. We must believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. So it's not about a feeling. Someone I'm speaking to this evening, they think I feel saved. I feel that I'm okay because I go to church. I've been going to church since I was a little girl. I know about the Lord. I know about Jesus. I went to Sunday school. You know, I even sang at the choir, you know. I went to functions at my church. Yes, I'm not going to church right now, but I know that I know that I know that I feel that I'm saved. God wants you to not have a feeling. He wants you to have that faith, and he wants you to exercise that faith and ask Jesus Christ into your Lord, because the Word of God says, if you confess with your mouth and you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is the Lord, he'll come into your heart. He will wash all your sins away, no matter how big it is, no matter how the magnitude of what you have done. There's nothing that his blood cannot cleanse, and he will wash away every sin as you ask in faith and you believe by faith that he has the power to forgive sins. Amen. He wants you to know that his blood is able to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. This says in Proverbs chapter 14, praise the name of the Lord, verse 12. Proverbs chapter 14, praise the name of the Lord. That's in the Old Testament. It's right after Psalms, the book of Psalms. Proverbs chapter 14. Let's turn to that scripture. Read in verse 12. And it reads as follows. It said, there's a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Amen. There's a way that seems, it feels right. You know, sometimes we go in on a path and the path feels right. Amen. Because you feel that you're going somewhere. You are reaching a destination. But that path might be the wrong road that you're taking. Many times, you know, in this life, we may take one wrong turn or make one wrong decision, and it can hold you back maybe many years of your life. Amen. It can bring you back 20 years in your life. It can bring you back 5 years of your life. When you're supposed to have been this far, then it brings you back, you know, way, way back, where, you know, it takes you another 10 years to get to that point where you're supposed to be, because you went on the wrong road or you made the wrong choice. Amen. The Word of God says that there's a way that seem right. It seem, it appears right. Amen. There's a way which seem, you know, there's a saying, all that glitter is not gold. It seem, sometimes things appear as if they are real or it's correct, but it's the real road that is leading straight to destruction. Amen. He said, there's a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. And many times, sometimes we get caught up in things that is not pertaining to life, and they are pertaining to death, but we don't see the death because the death is at the end. Amen. He said, but at the end thereof are the ways of death. But while you're on that path, it seemed to be life. It seemed to be correct. It seemed to be productive. It seemed to be energizing. But at the end, you know, you realize that This has led me to death. Amen. So we want to be on the right path. The Bible says, I set before you life and death. Choose life. So it's not about a feeling. It's about a choice that we make by faith. That's what salvation is. There's a way which seems right unto man, but the end thereof, you know, is death. The ways of death. Amen. There are many ways of death. Amen. It didn't so say the way of death, but the ways, plural, many ways. There's many things that you can do, and you may not see death in it, but the ways, there's different method that the same end results will be a portion. Amen. It may be one person may do one way. It might say, oh, well, I don't do drugs, so, you know, I'm not going to be ending up there. You know, you might say, oh, well, I'm not a prostitute. I don't fornicate. I'm not an adulterer. But whatever it is, you may say, no, this is not me, because you feel that you're on the right path. But there's some things that sometimes we don't see it because we are so involved that when we reach at the end, death is already there. So just a word to the wise. Salvation is given to us as a free gift from the Lord. Choose life and reject death in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Hallelujah. And we want him to be Lord over everything. Praise the name of the Lord.
Oh God. Hallelujah. Can somebody help me say that?
We worship you, oh God.
Anybody want to help me worship him?
We worship you, oh God.
Praise song. Hallelujah. Anybody want to demonstrate? We lift our hands in praise. We lift
our,
there you go. Hallelujah. Help me.
In praise.
Hallelujah. We lift our hands in praise. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. If you know him, just praise him. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun unto the going down of the saints. His name is worthy to be praised. Give him all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. Amen and amen. Praise the name of the Lord. There's a scripture in Jeremiah chapter 17. We're still on salvation. Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 9. It says, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? That's the question. So how could you trust your feelings and feel that you are saved and you did not ask Christ into your life? The Word of God says the heart is deceitful above all things. And you might say, well, I don't have anyone in my heart. I'm living a good life. You know, I don't have any unforgiveness. You know, I help others. And your list goes on and on. But, you know, the Word of God says it, that the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? God knows it. And God, that's why he sent his son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life, eternal life. And no matter what condition that you feel your heart is in, that it's a perfect heart, the Bible says the heart is deceitfully wicked above all things. It's deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. So David went to God, I praise the name of the Lord. And David was a man that when something went wrong, he always go to his maker. And we too have to take an example and say, you know, we must be like David. Because if the Word of God says the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked, then we have to try to fix it by the power of the Holy Spirit, by Jesus Christ, who is making intercessions for us. He has the power in the blood to do a job that we cannot do for ourselves, to clean up our act. Praise the name of the Lord. David said in Psalm 51 verse 10, create in me a clean heart. He knew he could not do it by himself. So he was asking God to create in him a clean heart. Amen. Oh God, he said, and renew a right spirit within me. Amen. So first he wanted his heart to be cleansed. And for the Holy Spirit to dwell in our heart has to be cleaned up. Amen. So before he asks for the right spirit, he first asks God to do a creative work in his heart, creating him a clean heart. And God is a God who spoke to things that was empty, void, without form in Genesis chapter 1. And life came, light came. So when we ask God to create in us a clean heart and renew in us a right spirit by the power of the blood of the Lamb, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he can clean up our heart. So then it wouldn't be deceitful and desperately wicked. It would not be wicked and deceitful. So David knew that when things go wrong and that his heart got tarnished and that his thinking was out of line with the Word of God, that on his action was not in line with the Word of God, you know, he can go ahead and advocate. He went to God as his high priest and he said, create in me a clean heart, O God. He did not go to his friend. He did not go to his spouse. He did not go to Jonathan. He didn't go to his neighbor. He went to God Almighty. He said, created me a clean heart. And he knew he could not do it by himself. But he asked for something else, renewing him a right spirit, which means that his spirit was all tarnished. Amen. And then when you have a renewing in him, a right spirit, he was asking for this, you know, that's cleansing. And so that the spirit of the Lord will dwell in him, that his spirit will come in line with God's plan for his life, with his God's word. Amen. So if you do not know Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior this evening, it's not about feeling, it's about faith. Amen. Because we do not always understand the things that might be in the depths of our heart. Amen. And it's good to go to God and ask God to search you and try you and see if there's anything that needs to be fixed. We cannot be so prideful and so self-confident that we think that all is well. No, we have to go daily and die daily to self and submit our hearts to Christ and say, yes, you know, Lord God, fix me. I cannot do it by myself. You are the potter and I am the clay. Shall we pray for that one who do not know you as Lord and Savior this evening, Lord God. Create a clean heart and a right spirit, your Holy Spirit, to dwell in that one. As that one confess with their mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord and believe in their heart that you died for their sins, O God. I ask you, O God, Father, Lord God, through the power of your blood, Lord Jesus, to cleanse that one from all unrighteousness. Wash that one white as snow. Create a clean heart. Give them your Holy Spirit, O God. Forgive every stain, every sin, anything that it does not line up with your word that have displeased you, Lord Father. I ask you for forgiveness, O God, as you have forgiven me, O God. Cleanse that one, O God, and bring them in right standing with you as they confess you as Lord and Savior. You said in your word that every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. So as they make that confession that Jesus Christ, you are Lord, I decree and I declare, O God, Father, Lord God, as they reach out and ask for forgiveness by the power of your Holy Spirit, by the power of your blood, and as they stand believing in faith that you have the power to forgive, I ask you for the Lord Father to cleanse, wash, oh God, and bring that one in right standing with you. I ask you to write that name in heaven, that in your book of life, that hell shall never be their portion, and heaven shall be that one's eternal home. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I decree and I declare on tonight, as you made that confession and you believe by faith that Jesus Christ is Lord, that salvation is yours and hell shall never be your portion. Heaven is your eternal home. Now, Father, I ask you to lead that one by your Spirit to, O God, a Spirit-filled church that, O God, is led by your power, the Holy Spirit, and that, O God, you will connect them to everyone that is connected to their destiny, and their lives, O God, shall be a sweet fragrance unto you and for your glory. So it is and so it shall be. Amen and amen. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Hallelujah. Give him all the praise. Hallelujah.
Come on, women of God, we lift
our hands. Men of God also, children of the Most High God, lift your hands and praise him.
We sing praises to your name, dear God.
We sing praises.
Come on, lift your voices and worship
your name.
In the midst of the heathen,
we sing praises to
glory to your name, Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Salvation is not about what we feel. You might feel saved, but tonight, as you said, yes, you made that confession that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you ask him to forgive you for your sins. You reached out in faith. You, by faith, has received the gift of eternal life. It's not what you feel. It's what God says. Not by might, not by power, but it's done by his Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise him.
Come on, open your mouth if he's done anything for you.
We sing praise.
Come on, worship him, women of God.
Your name.
Everyone, worship the Lord.
Lord. Come on, let's take it higher now. Let's take it higher.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus Christ is Lord. Hallelujah. And tonight, if you know that you're saved, but you are a little slipping away from him and, you know, doing your own thing, just move back into his presence. Amen. In his presence, there is fullness of joy. Amen. And there's pleasures forevermore. And, you know, he loves you. He loves us all. He loves all his children. And he wants us to make it into eternity. He says, work out our salvation with fear and trembling. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Hallelujah.
Praise.
Come on, women of God. We lift. We lift.
Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Last week we were teaching on faith. Praise the name of the Lord. And as we were going through the way faith works, Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Just to recap a little bit, Romans 10:17, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. We spoke concerning the word, that the word is spirit and it's life. Praise the name of the Lord, that our prayers, that's John 6:63. We spoke on from John 15:7, you know, that our prayers are answered through the word. You know, that God spoke his word as a vehicle of his faith in order to bring the universe into existence. He spoke things, he called for things that are not as though they were, and things came into being. And, you know, we have the authority to stand in his example and do what he does. Amen. Because his spirit lives within us. He has given us the authority to call things that are not as though they are. Hebrews 11, we see, you know, all those who believed in God and they stood in faith. Amen. Hebrews 11, especially verse 1 to 6, we went through that. So our faith can only produce a desired result or operate through the word of God, you know. John 5:24, we must, you know, activate our faith using the word of God also, because we can speak a thing, but if our faith is not according to the will of God, then we are asking amiss. Amen. Amiss. Because we have to ask according to God's will. Amen. So you're not going to ask God for something or to do something that you know that this is outside of God's will. Amen. His will is always manifested in his word. Amen. So we have to stay in his word so that we'll understand and comprehend his will. God holds all things together by his word, in terms of, we said in Hebrews 1:3, holds all things. He is not a man that he should lie. So when he says something, he's going to do it. We also spoke that he has positioned his word even higher than his name in Psalm 138:2. So his name is very powerful, but you know, his word is, he positioned it above his name. And that's something that we should look at. He said in John 1:1 that there's no difference between God and his word. They are very identical. They are identical. He said, you know, his word and him, they are the same. So we have to receive him through salvation, and we have to now live by his word. Amen. Because his word is spirit and it's life. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. In Joshua 1, praise the name of the Lord. Joshua 1:8, we had this instruction. It said, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Amen. So God says, you know, God was giving this instruction to Joshua, and he's giving us the same thing to us. He's saying, you know, to study thyself, approve, so that we can rightly divide the word of truth. Amen. So he says, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, which means that we must speak the word of God. We must speak his word. We must activate our faith by using his word. Amen. We are still on the subject of the topic of faith. So he said, this book of the Lord shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate therein day and night. To meditate is to think long harder on something, to ponder on that thing. Many times we read the word of God, or we hear the word of God. You go to church, you hear the word of God, and you know, by the time you get home, sometimes, you know, half of the word is gone, because, you know, you didn't take a note of the scripture. You didn't, you know, file it into your heart. It stayed in your head, and it didn't go into your spirit. So we have to meditate on the word of God. Take a note of things. In Habakkuk chapter 2, he says, write the vision down, right? Write it down and make it plain, that he that read it will run with it. You know, so some things, you know, when we get a revelation of the word of God, even, it does not only mean, you know, that a vision that you see in terms of day vision or a night vision, you know, something just of like in terms of vision, but whatever God has revealed to you. Amen. You know, whatever has come to your knowledge, write the thing down. You know, Habakkuk says in Habakkuk chapter 2, he said, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon the tower. Habakkuk 2 verse 1, I'm reading from. He said, and will watch to see what he will say unto me, and what I will answer when I'm reproved. The Lord answered me and said, write the vision, Make it plain upon tablets, that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Amen. So he went on to say, behold, his soul which is lifted up, that's verse 4, is not upright in him, but the just shall live by his faith. Amen. Sometimes we say, the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by his faith. What measure of faith do you have? The just shall live by the faith that he's going to put out, that God is going to see and God is going to do as you exercise your faith. Amen. So Habakkuk was making a determination here. He said, I will stand watch. You know, he had an expectation and he wanted to see what God will do. Amen. Sometimes we have faith, but we don't have the patience to wait on God. Amen. Psalm 46 verse 10 says, be still and know that I am God. Many times we lose the victory because we are not waiting with an expectation that God will come through for us. Amen. We think that because he didn't come through at his time, at our timing, that he has failed us, or he has not, he has not answered your prayers, or he has not heard you. He said his ears are open unto us, our cry. And sometimes when we ask God some things, even though we maybe have asked according to his will, maybe the time is not perfect, because that's not a time in God's timetable. Amen. He says in his word in Ecclesiastes, he says that to everything there's a time, a season, and a purpose for everything under the sun. And sometimes when we don't get things right away, we get, you know, despondent, we get depressed, you know. But God wants you to stand in faith. Do not cast your confidence away. Stand in faith and believe God, and know that he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above everything you can ask him or anything you can think about. Amen. As long as it's according to the will of God, he's going to do it for you, or he has the capabilities to do for you. If he does not do it, then he has another plan for you. Maybe he's working patience in you. Maybe he's brought you some tribulation, so that tribulation worketh patience, because after you would finish that tribulation, he's building strength in you. Amen. So some things we go through different things, some through the water, some through the fire, all through the blood. Amen. He you are going through, that means you are coming out. Whatever you may be going through tonight, stand in faith and believe. Do like Habakkuk did. Set a watch. Say, God, you know, I know by before the end of this year, you're going to do this for me, and I believe in faith. I'm standing in faith that you are capable, you are able, and you are God of truth. And I believe that I'm asking according to your word, and I have an expectation that it will be done according to your will. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the name of the Lord. God wants you to trust him where you don't see him, because many times he does not show up the way you expect him to show up. Amen. Trust him, but you must stand believing. Amen. Write the things down that you ask in God. Sometimes it's good to write things down. Write down the things that you want to God to do for you this year. Write them down. Pray them. Incorporate them in your prayer and say, God, this is what I want to do. I have this habit. I can't shake it by myself, but I'm asking the power of the Holy Spirit to deliver me from this temptation, deliver me from this chaos. It might be something that you need to God to do in your finances, and you know, we all have different struggles, but God wants you to say to him, you are able to help me. And when you ask him, David says, you know, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. You have to make him your shepherd. You have to give him the permission to lead you. You have to give him the freedom to lead you. Amen. He's not going to badger into your life. He wants you to accept him as the Lord and Savior. He wants you to put him first place in your life. He wants you to trust him with all your heart. He don't want you to go by your mind, because your mind could lead you into feeling things that are not real. So we must trust him by faith. Amen. He says, you know, we must come with childlike faith and believe. Come in his presence and ask of him. Present your case to him with strong reason. Praise the name of the Lord. He's a marvelous God. He's a wonderful God. And he wants to help you. Praise the name of the Lord. But you must know that you need to have that faith that he can do it for you. Amen and amen. He brought you to another year, and you are here for a purpose. Trust him with all your heart. Praise the name of the Lord.
We just want to tell him how wonderful he is, how marvelous and excellent he is. Because that's all we see when we look at ourselves. Because we don't know how we got here. That's all we want to say. How wonderful you are. Come on, let me hear you.
A wonderful God.
You are.
You are.
To me.
To me.
That's what you are, Jesus.
A wonderful God.
You are.
You are.
To me.
To me.
Praise the name of the Lord. You might be waiting on something, but He's still a wonderful God to you. You made it to 2016. You didn't get everything that you needed or wanted, desired, hoped for in that year. Not that 2015, 14, 13, many years before that. But you do not know what He's going to do in 2017. Trust Him because He has been marvelous to you. Many did not make it into 2016. Many have been caught in crossfires and violence and so many other things. You know, weather condition has swept them away. You know, sickness, disease, infirmity. But you are still here, and where there is life, there is hope. He has been wonderful to you. Give Him the glory. Give Him the praise. Give Him the honor. Have faith in Him. Trust Him. Believe Him. Stand on His word. Stand on His promises. Live by His word. Don't just be a hearer of it, but be a doer of His word. Amen. Stay in the word of God. Have faith in God, according to Mark 11:22. Have faith in God. He's a wonderful God. Hallelujah.
You are.
Activate your faith this year by reading the word of God, by meditating on it. Think hard on it. Ask God, wait in His presence. Sometimes we pray and we don't wait in God's presence to hear what He's saying to us. Just lie still and hear. Say, Lord, Spirit of the living God, speak to me. Because prayer is communication with God, and it's a two-way thing. Amen. You pray, you speak, and there's a listener on the other end. God Almighty's ears are open unto our cry. Stay in His presence and hear what He's saying to you on this year. Amen. Fill up on His word. Read His word. Study His word. Meditate on His word. But most important, do what His word says. Amen. Don't just be a hearer of the word, but become a doer of His word, so that we'll all make it into God's kingdom. God's word is a fire and a hammer. It has the potential to change, to transform, to purify, to delete. It can do anything, because God's word is a two-edged sword. Amen. It can cut, it can heal, it can restructure, and it can rejuvenate you. Anything that you want, whatever you are looking for, it starts with salvation. Jesus Christ must be Lord of your life. And as you give Him your heart, as you surrender to Him, He wants all of you, and He wants to transform you so that He can use you for His glory. And when you stand in His presence, He can say, wait a minute. You know, He can say, well done, my good and faithful servants. You were created for His glory, but you must have that faith to believe that you are not just wandering in life. You're not just wandering wrong in life. You go to work, you come back, you eat, you sleep, you wake. No, you have a purpose. Your purpose might be fulfilled on the job that you are on. Your purpose might be filled in your neighborhood. It might be on your church. It might be just wherever you go, He wants to use you for His glory. Amen. You were created with a destiny and a purpose. Ask Him, what is my reason for living? Why did you bring me into 2017? Why am I here in this? Why did you create me? I know you created me with a divine purpose. I have faith and I believe that my life means something to you. So show me, what is my purpose? Don't just wander in this life. Some objectives, some goals, but have them centered based on what God has revealed to you, even in His word. And He would reveal Himself to you as you search Him. He will manifest Himself to you as you search His word, as you draw close to Him. Have faith in God. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord.
Yes, you are to me.
Many times we don't have some things because, or we don't see the manifestation of God power, because you know, the just shall live by faith. It says in Romans 1:17, Galatians 3:11, Hebrews 10:38, praise the name of the Lord, in Habakkuk 2:4, the just shall live by faith. There's so many times when God told us that the just shall live by faith. Galatians 3:11, the just shall live by faith. Hebrews 10:38, the just shall live by faith. Habakkuk 2:4. Why, God? Because God is showing us a lifestyle, how we should live by faith and not by sight. Our sight can deceive us, amen? Because sometimes, you know what the word of God said, we have eyes to see and we see not. We have ears to hear and we hear not. So if you want to live by faith this year, we have to ask God that we give us the power and give us the confidence to not look with the eyes of just the natural. Amen. We can't live by sight. We live by faith and not by sight. Amen. The things that we see are sometimes are temporary. Sometimes we may be in a situation and the thing might be a temporary situation, but God has a permanent outcome that is greater than your expectation. But you will not know that because guess what? You are seeing in the natural. He wants you to stretch, because faith is dealing with the supernatural, because you don't possess that thing yet, but you believe that it's there in the supernatural and it's going to be released into the natural. So you have to have that confidence to know that that thing is there and it's attainable, it's reachable, because God is the God of impossibilities. God is the God who said there's nothing impossible with him. Praise the name of the Lord. He is a supernatural God. He's a wonderful God. He's a great God. He's a mighty God, amen? So he wants you to believe him, trust him, trust his word.
To me, you are Jehovah, you are our Father. There is nobody like you, there is nobody like you. Nobody compares to you, nobody compares to you, nobody compares to you, nobody compares to you.
Praise the name of the Lord. In order for faith to work, we must come in agreement with his word. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. We must come in agreement with his word. Many times we don't come in agreement with his word. Amen. We do not come in agreement with his word. His word says one thing, but our mind is saying something else. Praise the name of the Lord. We are not in line with his word. We are seeing things from our own eyes. Come in agreement with his word. Philippians 4:13 said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. That's faith, that to believe that there's nothing that you cannot do, because Christ, the hope of glory, will help you to accomplish it, because he's going to do it for you. Amen. Through him we can do all things, not through our own ability. Our own ability, we cannot do anything, because we cannot even breathe without him. We cannot even stay alive without him. Amen. But we can do all things, not just something, through Christ who strengthens us. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. There was a time when I remember, you know, being sick and I, you know, was not able to walk. And the doctor says, you know, you're going to be in a wheelchair. You know, next year, this time, you'll be in a wheelchair. And, you know, it was one devastating thing that I heard, that I'm going to be in a wheelchair. But I didn't receive it into my spirit. I believed that this doctor is a physician, but I have a great physician and he's in charge of my life. It took me a lot of struggles and a lot of pain and a lot of what I should say, dark days. But in time, in God's time, I was able to walk without using a cane and without using a neck brace and a back brace. I was able to wear shoes and different things. You know, that's you know, part of my testimony. But I'm just saying to someone this evening, do not limit God. Amen. Because you can do all things only through Christ who strengthens you. Amen. And what he done for others, he can do for you. He healed the sick. He raised the dead. He set the captive free. That is why Jesus came. And he came that you will have life and have it more abundantly. Yes, you'll have terrible days. Yes, you'll have challenging days. Yes, you'll have some tribulation. We all have to bear a cross, because he said, guess what? After you will be have your crown. But we, you know, we must embrace this salvation and not see it as, you know, every day will be a day of glory. But, you know, to push ourselves to believe and walk out our salvation with fear and trembling when the challenges come. Have faith in God. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, according to Philippians 4:13. The smallest measure of faith, the smallest faith, which is mustard seed faith,
can relocate a mountain, I said, and clear the way for your breakthrough to be visible and to be obtainable. Amen. Sometimes we see the breakthrough, but we're not able to obtain the breakthrough because we don't have all that faith that we believe it to the end. Amen. So the smallest measure of faith can relocate a mountain and put it in the sea. Amen. Whereas this is an unfavorable condition for a mountain to be. So eventually the mountain will dissolve, but we must have that patience to wait for this to happen. Amen. Your breakthrough to be visible and not be able to obtain it is not good. When you have your breakthrough, you see your breakthrough and you know God is able to do it, you must have that strength to press on in faith, because faith is activated, it's voice activated, and it's something that you do. Amen. It is something that's in motion. You praise God, you thank Him, you believe all of these things, you worship Him, all of these things. You don't just sit and wait. You know, even though the word of God said, be still and know that I'm God, it just means don't go out of line. But you have to pray. You don't stop praying. You don't stop worshiping God. You don't start thanking Him for the things you don't see yet. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Because of time, I'm going to stop here. And I'm going to just say to you, for who do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, trust Him. Believe Him. Take Him as His word. Do His word. But make sure that your salvation is not just about a feeling, but that's about faith, that you really truly believe that Jesus Christ is the only way, the only truth, and the only life. Don't just feel this. Oh, I've been going to this. I'm a member of this congregation. I'm the member of this denomination. No, it's not about a denomination. You can have your membership. You can be a Gold Star member. And you may not make it into heaven because you have not had a born again experience where you said, Jesus Christ, you are Lord over my life, and I put you first place. Everything else in my life, they are additions, and you are the only way, you are the truth, and you are the life. And I ask you to forgive me for everything I've done. I repent of my sin, which means I'm not going backwards, I'm going forward in you. And I believe with all my heart that you have died for me and that you have forgiven me, and the Holy Spirit dwell inside of me. Because when you give your heart to Christ, the Holy Spirit come and take residence in you. That's what salvation is. Have faith in God, but your salvation begins with having faith in God. Praise the name of the Lord. If you are saved and you are having struggles and challenges this year, you know, the year started you off with so many challenges, have faith in God. The way you start, you don't mean that you're going to end it with challenges. You have to believe God that things are getting better, and things has the potential to be better because God is on the throne in your life. Amen. Be a witness for the Lord. Tell someone about Jesus. Be in the word. Trust the word of God. Take God at His word, and have that faith to believe that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Father, Lord God, we thank you for your word. Thank you for saving someone this evening as they have listened to your word. That tonight, even at their bedtime, even while we are praying here, that they will say, yes, Jesus Christ is Lord. And they will ask you into their heart by confessing you as Lord and Savior. Thank you for breakthroughs and blessings. Thank you for forgiving sins. Oh God, big ones, small ones, in between ones, all sins. We thank you, Lord God, that you have cleansed someone from all unrighteousness and washed them white as snow. And Father, that your Holy Spirit, oh God, has taken residence in that heart. I thank you, oh God, for that one who has an expectation, oh God, of a better year this year, that they'll walk in faith and not by sight, and believe that they can do all things only to you, Christ, who strengthens them. I decree the strength of the Lord to sustain each one of us, oh God, that we'll make it into your kingdom. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. Jesus Christ is Lord. This is Choice Gospel Radio. You have been listening to Salvation and Revelation, a program brought to you by Choice Gospel Radio. Your life, your salvation, and your choice maker. May you be blessed as you continue to listen to Choice Gospel Radio, 92.9 FM. Today, you know, it's a day that, you know, we just thank God for being in the land of the living, and God continue to bless you with long life, with health, and with strength. Amen. May God continue to draw you close to Him. As you draw close to Him, He will draw close to you. May God give you the measure
of the things poured onto you, the measures that you are asking from him, by the measure of your faith, that you will exercise your faith and obtain the things that you are seeking him for. By his will, he will do it for you, because his will is always perfect. Praise the name of the Lord. If this program has been a blessing to you, I urge you to be supportive to this ministry. We are not here about filthy lucre or money. We are here to preach the gospel, the truth of the word of God. And if you have, we have blessed this, the word has been a blessing to you, the station has been a blessing to you, send your donation, send an offering to this ministry to support us, so that we can continue to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. The Choice Gospel Network, P.O. Box 30016, Brooklyn, New York 11203. Again, we are not here to make money for ourselves or anything. We're just here to preach the word of God. But if this word, this station has been a blessing to you, you can send your donations to Choice Gospel Network, P.O. Box 30016, Brooklyn, New York 11203. Or you can call us at 718-715-4415 if you need to speak to the man of God. Praise the name of the Lord, Minister Straker. God bless him, and God bless this ministry. God bless you too. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. God. Have a pleasant good evening. As you continue listening to the word of God.
We are here because of his grace and mercy. He is a wonderful God. We just want to tell him how wonderful he is, how marvelous and excellent he is. Because that's all we see when we look at ourselves. Because we don't know how we got here. That's all we want to say. How wonderful you are. Come on, let me hear you.
A wonderful God.
You are.
You are.
To me.
To me.
That's what you are, Jesus.
A wonderful God.
You are.
You are.
To me.
To me.
You're a wonderful God.
My wonderful
every day
you are
to me.
You
want to say it one more time? Join us if you want.
A wonderful God.
That's what you are.
You are
to me. What a wonderful.